वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 5, वेलकम बैक टू योर SST क्लास एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 2 एज योर रिवीजन. इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1. सो टेक आउट योर SST बुक्स एंड नोटबुक्स एंड टेक अ लुक ओवर हियर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर हैविंग सर्कम नेविगेशन इन द वर्ड बैंक एक्सरसाइजेस. What do we mean by circumnavigation? It means traveling all the way around the earth to reach back to the starting point. Means when we travel all around the world in the earth and then we reach back to that same point. Grid, crisscross pattern, or we can say a pattern of straight line that cross each other and form a series of squares. Then we have pole, which means it is the end point of the top or the bottom of any of the surface. But here we will write it as either of the end points or at the top or bottom of the earth's axis. Then we are having axis, which means an imaginary line of earth which passes through its center. Then we are having longitude. What does longitude mean? It is an imaginary line that runs vertically from the direction north to south. Next is parallel, which means the lines which run side by side with the same distance. But here we will write the definition running side by side with the same distance at every point. Then we are having latitude. What does latitude means? It means the lines which circles the earth from east to west. So here the definition is given, imaginary lines circling around the earth from east to west. Then we will move on to circle the correct options. First is how many lines of latitude are there. As we have studied in the latitude topic, then we have 181 lines. So here we will put the circle, we will mark the circle on 181. Then we have who circumnavigated the earth to prove that it is spherical in shape. As I have told you earlier also, that a Portuguese explorer named Ferdinand Magellan explored, or we can say circumnavigated, that earth is spherical in shape. So here we will circle the Ferdinand Magellan. Which line of longitude is assumed to be the crossing the Royal Observatory in Greenwich? It is prime meridian. While we were discussing about the prime meridian topic in this chapter, I have told you that it crossed the Royal Observatory in Greenwich. So it means prime meridian. Which latitude is also called the Great Circle? Which latitude is called? Obviously, equator is called the latitude of Great Circle. What is the network of intersecting lines used to find the exact location of a place? So, exact network of connecting line is known as grid. Now, we will move on to exercise B, which is fill in the blanks. The shape of the earth is like an sphere, but slightly flattened at the top and at the bottom. That is why we mean it as ganoid. Lines of longitudes or meet at the poles and they are farthest apart at the equator. Lines of latitudes are parallel equidistant line at a distance of 1 degree towards the north and the south from the equator. Then we are having dash is located at 66.5 degrees south from the equator, which was the circle which was located at the 66.5 degrees south from the equator. It was circle of illumination. So here we will write circle of illumination. The lines of longitude run from north to south pole. So here we will write north to south. Then we will move on to answer the following questions in short. First of all, we are having what are longitudes and latitudes. So longitudes are the imaginary lines that run vertically from north to south. This we have discussed in fill in the blanks right now. and latitudes are imaginary lines circling around the earth from east to west. So where longitudes run from north to south, latitude lines circle around the earth from east to west. Then we are having name some important lines of latitude. So what are some of the important lines of latitude? They are Arctic Circle, Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, Antarctic Circle. Then what is the prime meridian? The prime meridian is the standard line of longitude assumed to be crossing the Royal Observatory in Greenwich near London. It is marked at 0 degree. This longitude divides the world into two equal halves. How many lines of latitude are there? There are 181 lines of latitude. Next, we are having long answers. So how do we find the location of a place on the earth? The vertical and horizontal lines, known as longitudes and latitudes, respectively make a network of intersecting lines. The points where these lines intersect each other provide us a location coordinate, which help us in locating a place on earth. Now we are having differentiate between longitudes and latitudes. So longitudes are imaginary lines that run vertically from the north to the south, whereas latitude are imaginary line circling around the earth from east to the west. And the last question we are having here is, who proved that the earth is spherical in shape and how? So in the 16th century, a Portuguese explorer, Ferdinand Magellan, set an expedition. He started his journey from Seville in Spain in 1590. Though he died on the way, the voyage was completed by his second in command, who was Juan Sebastian Elcano, in 1522. When the latter reached Seville and proved by his circumnavigation that the earth was spherical in shape. So children, here we have discussed the exercises of chapter number 2. I hope you all have understood it. So today you have to learn and write these exercises as your revision. And in my next video, we are going to start with the revision of chapter number 3. Thank you for today's class and have a nice day.